It is 2 days later, the final of the women's individual all-around. 36 women qualify for the finals. All of the events are contested simultaneously. The finalists are divided into four groups of nine. Four events would be contested: the uneven bars, balance beam, vault, and floor exercise. The team championship has a direct bearing on the individual all-around title. Half of each gymnast's total points in the team competition are carried over and added to the points earned in the individual all-around competition. It is evident that the battle for top honors will be amongst three. In first place, by 40 hundredths of a point, Nadia Comaneci. Tied for second, Ludmila Turisheva and Nelly Kim of the Soviet Union. In fifth place, more than a half a point behind Comaneci, Olga Korbut of the Soviet Union. There is additional drama. Comaneci and Turisheva will be in the same group. The first apparatus for Turisheva and Comaneci is the vault. Comaneci is awarded a 9.85. Turisheva is next. The great champion is near perfect, 9.95. She takes sole possession of second place behind Comaneci. Now Olga Korbut on the balance beam.
I remember very curiously that people sort of very quickly lost their taste in Olga. She was like the old lady. I mean, good Lord, what was she, 21, 22 years old or something? But she was so very quickly surpassed by Nadia and by the other newcomers. If ever we had the sense that sports is a throwaway society, it was in Montreal with Olga. She was yesterday's newspaper very quickly.
She scores a 9.50. She is now out of contention for one of the medals. The second rotation, the uneven bars. Turisheva scores a 9.80. Now it is time for Nadia Comaneci in her favorite event.
Nadia particularly was a very, very quiet, very inside person. But at the same time, you could see always in her eyes the steel wheel of performing. She wanted to perform perfectly. She wanted to enjoy being the best among the group.
She scores a perfect 10. Her third on that apparatus and fourth overall. Nadia now leads Turisheva by 50 hundredths of a point and Kim by 60 hundredths. Though this 14-year-old is in the lead, she does not feel the pressure.
The only pressure you have when you are a kid is that you want to do good. When you're a kid, you don't know about pressure. What is pressure anyway?
In the third rotation, the beam, Nadia scores another perfect 10. Turisheva scores a 9.85. Kim becomes the second gymnast ever to score a 10. A magnificent effort puts her back into second place behind Nadia by 60 hundredths of a point. Turisheva is pushed back to third, 65 hundredths off the lead. Now the fourth and final rotation. Kim on the uneven bars scores a 9.90. While While Tereshova turns in a 9.90 on the floor exercise, she knows that she has lost the individual all-around title.
I knew that it is very difficult to hold on to first place. Like everything else, my sport must continue to grow. There is a time for everything. A time for me, a time for others. Between Munich, when I was a champion, and Montreal, Nadia Comaneci came onto the scene, and it was the beginning of a new era in gymnastics.
Now it is Nadia's turn on the floor exercise. Only a disaster can prevent her from winning the gold medal.
Finally, Nadia comes up and does her incredible routine. That's where the crowd exploded. I mean, that was explosion of support, explosion of love and excitement. And I'm looking from the corner of my eyes and I see the Soviet team getting their stuff and they walk in out of the arena. I said, yes, yes, we got it.
14-year-old Nadia Comaneci has won the individual all-around championship by 60 hundredths of a point over Nellie Kim and 65 hundredths of a point better than Ludmila Tereshova in third place. Later, the award ceremony takes place. What started as a somber Olympic Games with the African boycott has turned into a spectacular one because of the genius of a 4'11" 14-year-old named Nadia Comaneci.
I mean, it's hard to believe for me that I made such a big impact in 76. Because, you know, what did I do?
She really saved the games. She came on the first night, made her first 10 on the first night, and all of the agony, all of the anguish, all of everybody saying this won't work, all of the African nations pulling out, was just suddenly wiped out by this one little girl. Nobody had the foggiest idea who she was or where she'd come from, and she absolutely saved the Olympics.